एलिफेंट इन द रूम, ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। So Ahmed and Maryam, they both have learned a bit of organic chemistry with me because we didn't have much time, so they just had a glance. But still, let us start with a question. Number of organic molecules. Can somebody put up in the chat? What do you think? How many organic molecules are present? Any guess? How many organic molecules? I mean, a number. Can you put up a number, Maryam? Are present. Okay, fine. Maryam is saying around 500. Yes. What about you, Ahmed? Any? Yes. Just put up any number. Absurdly big, absurdly small. Also, Amalia, Fatima. Ahmed is saying millions. Okay. And also organic molecules, unique organic molecules. Okay, unique. Amalia and Fatima are still thinking or what? Amalia is also saying millions. Okay. Fatima? Okay, is Fatima, am I audible? I don't know. I'm not asking you if you are knowing or not. I am asking, just guess anything. You can guess. I guess Fatima does not want to guess. Ahmed is saying 90 million. Did you Google that, Ahmed? Some accurate number, 90 million?
Yes, sir.
Can you check that? Is it for organic and inorganic combined or
just so organic? Unique organic.
Unique organic? Can you read that statement, what you have got in your Google?
The ice type for how many organic unique molecules are there, and it was like 90 million unique organic.
No. And can you read? Do you have that tab open till now?
No, sir.
No? Okay. Not 90 million. I guess that would be, I mean, if you unique organic molecules, and it would be written like 90 million unique organic
and inorganic.
And inorganic is there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So organic molecules are close to 20 million. Unique organic molecules are close to 20 million. The correct answer is close to 20 million. 20 million. 20 million. So just to get an idea of 20 million, how much is 20 million? Basically, we don't have sometimes idea of 20 million. Okay. That is how much it is? 10 to the power of 6. 10 to the power of 6. So if I say you spend 1 million, if you have this much amount of currency in whatever terms you like it, okay, you have this much amount of currency and you spend 1 million each day, 1 million each day, okay, now calculate how many years will it take to completely extinguish and exhaust your this much amount of money. You're spending
in one day, how much?
You're spending in one day, you're spending 1 million.
Say 20 days.
1 million
Say if we spend 1 million one day, then it will take us 20 days to complete 20 million.
Yeah, exactly. You will take 20 million. Now, calculate how many seconds is 20 million? How many seconds? If you have 20 million seconds, how much hours or days it is?
Say 20 days to complete 20 million.
Ah, that is correct. That is correct. Now I'm asking, if you have 20 million seconds, then how many days it is? It will be 20 into 10 to the power 6 upon 60 into 60 into 24. This will come approximately equal to 231 days. This will come approximately equal to 231 days. So this much, just to get an idea, I mean, if you have 231 days, which is almost near to 9 months or 8 to 9 months. So this much amount of organic molecules is there. If you start reading organic molecules for 1 second, you are seeing one organic molecule, it will take 231 days to just see those organic molecules. Okay. So the first thing that I want to remove from your mind is organic chemistry is not based upon, it is not based upon memorization. Okay. Organic chemistry, OChem, is not based upon memorization. Okay. So what is this, what it is based upon? It is based upon rules. It is based upon rules. There are two type of reasonings. Okay. Reasoning that we see in a logical reasoning. The first, it is known as heuristic. Heuristics. And the second one is, and not, and the other is known as algorithmic. What is heuristic? Heuristic is like rules. You have some set of rules, you have to just follow it. Similarly, Ahmed will relate to it very well. If you drive, you have some rules. Like when you are hitting some bumpers, you have to gear down. How much gear downs? You have to see. If you are on fourth gear, you can just combine it to do like three gears. You have to slow it down. How much to slow it down? You have to have practice, then you will come to know how much you have to slow down. If you want to go from point A to point B, there is one preferred way of going from point A to point B, but if you get traffic somewhere else, you have to revert the path. And it does not mean that you have to memorize all the paths. You just have to know the directions where it is and just have some kind of idea how it is going on. So as it is based on rules, and similarly, it is probabilistic, right? It is probabilistic. So you must be seeing there are major products. You have done major products and minor products in organic chemistry, right? So there are two pathways. No? It is getting major and minor. It is probabilistic. So majority of the time, major product is this, then this is an minority. Now, what is algorithmics? The last chapter that we were doing, solutions, it is just algorithmic. You have to find this, and this, then you will get the answer. So you will get given some input. Then you have to follow instruction. Now, if I say calculate this, then you will get the answer. Follow instruction. Then get answer. Okay. So this is the main point that it is not, first of all, it is not based upon, I'm also emphasizing on the fact that it is not based on memorization. Memorization helps, no doubt, but it is not based on memorization. It is process based and not answer based. Okay. It is process based. It's process based and not answer based. It's not answer based. This is, all these terms, my old student must be knowing it is not based upon memorization, but still I will say memorization helps, and more so in your case, memorization helps because you have a very small set of reactions that you have to know. Okay. When the reaction becomes very huge, like further when you study chemistry, it becomes very large set of reactions, then it becomes harder. For example, in the master's level, if you are doing MSc in chemistry, you have to know at least around 250 named reactions. That means 250 reactions which are named after some scientist. You have to know at least 250 named reactions. Okay. So for now, you have approximately, I will guess, around you have something 20 named reaction or 230 named reaction at max you have to learn. Okay. 20 to 30. And you can easily remember because they are categorized in different chapters. Now let me start formally what is about organic chemistry, and mainly we will be dealing with reactions. So a typical organic reaction, how does this look? A typical organic reaction in which we have substrate, I should say initially reactants they react with each other, and they can either form an intermediate. There will be some intermediate, or there will be some transition step, and after that we will be getting product. So the idea is to, what is the main idea? The goal is to study the reactant and predict the intermediate. Then what we have to do? We have to study the intermediate and predict the product. So first of all, we will study the reactants. What are reactants? So reactants can be classified into two different terms. Reactants can be either reagents or substrate. What is reagent? Reagent is that chemical species. It is a chemical species that attacks. And the other part is substrate. It is the organic chemical species, that gets attacked. Now this is reagent and this is substrate. So you can copy this slide, a typical organic reaction. This slide just with this for your first introduction to chemistry. Okay, understand this point. We have to study the reactant so well. Okay, we will see what is the property of reactant that it is giving a particular product. What product can it give? We will study the reactants and intermediate. We will not worry about the product as of now. We will not worry about the product as of now. We will study about reactants and intermediates. let me know when you're done copying this. Raise your hand and let me know. Waiting for Fatima and Mariam. Waiting for Mariam. Mariam, done?
Just a second.
Okay, fine.
Done,
so in this we have reagent and then we have substrate. Okay, so reagents can be of two types. Reagents can be of two types. Okay, so either they are electrophiles. Electrophile. So what is electrophile? Electrophile mean what? Electron loving. Okay. So if it is electron loving, so it will like electron, likes electrons, gets attracted to, electrons, and hence if something is getting attracted to electrons, it must be what? It must be electron deficient. It will be what? It will be electron deficient. The next one is nucleophile. Nucleophiles are what? Nucleophiles are that chemical species which are nucleus loving. So if they are nucleus loving, what is the charge of nucleus, Fatima?
Positive
charge. That means it must be what? It must be electron rich. Okay, this must be electron rich. Okay. So basically in each and every reaction, you will identify the electrophiles and the nucleophiles. If you have identified the electrophile, then you have to identify the nucleophilic site in the substrate. Okay. That is what we will be doing. Okay. So reagents can be of two types, either electrophiles or nucleophiles. And each and every reactive site will be also of either electrophilic or nucleophilic. Now let us come to intermediates. That is when we have some reactants that react, we get intermediates. So there is some kind of bond breaking and then we get intermediates. So I can write cleavage of bonds and intermediates. Okay. So the first cleavage that can happen is called homolytic. So in homolytic cleavage, what happens? We have a molecule like this, A and A, and when the bond breaks, cleavage is nothing but breakage of bond. Bond breaks, and this shared pair of electrons is now distributed and broken between both of them. So it gets A free radical, and we get another A free radical. Okay, it's known as free radicals. It is how this homolytic. It is homolytic cleavage. It happens when bond breaks. Bond breaks, and the shared pair of electron and the shared pair of electron is equally distributed to the species formed. So here we have what? Here we have A and A, the bond breaks and we get A free radical. That means one electron is moving to A and the another electron is moving to different A. Okay. And as you can see here, we have a fish hook arrow, that is a single headed arrow. And in contrast to homolytic, we have heterolytic cleavage. We have heterolytic cleavage. Heterolytic cleavage. In heterolytic cleavage, what happens? We have A, which is bonded to B. In this, the whole shared pair of electrons goes to one atom. Okay, that is B. So A has now, A is devoid of one electron. So it will become what? A plus, and B will become what? B negative. These are what? Ions. They are what? Ions. So I get what? Breakage of bonds. Bonds in which shared pair of electron goes to more electronegative atom. Okay, shared pair of electron goes to most electronegative atom. So I can say En of electronegativity of B is greater than A. That is why B is able to pull electrons and take it away, and it is forming ions and form electronegative ion atom and form cations and anions. Cations and anion. Cation is A plus and B is anion. Write this slide down. Up till here, do you have any doubt? Let me know, please, if you have any doubt.
Sir, can you explain heterolytic cleavage again?
Heterolytic cleavage again?
Homolytic also.
Do you want to understand how it is happening or what it is?
So what it is and how it is happening.
No, you have to now just understand what it is. Okay. I mean, where if you see something, then you will identify it as it is homolytic cleavage. So homolytic cleavage, the basically idea is if you have a compound in which we have same type, for example, we have H2, hydrogen and hydrogen. And if you want to break hydrogen and hydrogen, if you want to break it homolytically, and it breaks homolytically in most of the cases because the electronegativity is same. We want to break this particular bond. If you want to see how the bonds are shared, then you can see that H and H, it is equally shared. Okay, so the electron will be similarly like this. There is no partiality between electrons. So if you go, then the most probability is that one of each of the hydrogens will be getting one electron. But for example, if I have something like HCl, and if I want to see HCl is like this, which is more electronegative, chlorine is more electronegative. So the more portion of electrons will be towards what? It will be towards chlorine. Am I right about this? More electrons will be towards chlorine. And if I break, the most probability is that HCl will break as H plus and Cl negative. Also, now again, once again, it is not the case that every time we break homonuclear molecule. Homonuclear means it means that both the nucleus in this molecule is of the same atom. In homonuclear, it is not 100% that you will always get homolytic, but in some cases you get homolytic cleavage. In some cases, homolytic cleavage. You have to just recognize where it is homolytic and where it is heterolytic. This is just the names that you have to now keep in mind. Some terminologies. As we say, electrophile and nucleophile. Similarly, what is homolytic and what is heterolytic? How it will happen, when it will happen, slowly and slowly when you will see a particular reactions, you will be understand. Okay, fine. Here it is homolytic cleavage. Here it is heterolytic cleavage. As we have, as of now, we are just getting introduced to terminologies that we are going to use in organic chemistry. Okay, done. I mean, write this, or answer. I have written this slide. Okay, fine. Yeah, write this slide. Done. We're just waiting for Mariam.
Sir?
Yes.
What is EN of B?
What is the? Sorry?
EN of B, you wrote in heterolytic cleavage.
I've written EN. Achha, this is electronegativity. Electronegativity. Done. I guess everyone is done. Okay, now there is one thing which we have structure and then we have the reactivity. Okay, there is a relationship between structure and reactivity. Okay. Now. What do you think is the simplest organic class of molecules? Yes, can I have Fatima? What do you think is the simplest class of organic molecules? So you can say simplest organic molecule. Okay, fine. Yes, Mariam has said, right? Simplest class of organic molecules. Mariam has said CH4. Fatima, I'm asking others. Tell me, please, what do you have an idea about? Amalia is like acetone. Okay, fine. Simplest. Amalia has heard acetone too much or what? Is that the case? Fatima is methane. What about Ahmed? What do you think is the simplest class of organic molecules? Remember the organic molecules that you learned the first. Yes, Ahmed?
Ethanol.
Okay, and what is the first organic molecule that you learned in 10th standard? Methanol? Mm-hmm. I don't think so.
Methane.
You learned about homologous series, if I am right. First organic molecules that you learned about was alkenes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, that was the first organic molecule, alkenes. So as of now, when you are starting with organic chemistry, as of now, what you will see alkenes as the most unreactive molecules. Okay, alkenes react. It is no doubt alkenes react, but as of now you will see alkenes that they are the least reactive molecules. Okay, other than that they are more reactive. So for example, now I'm making one molecule, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2 and chlorine. Okay, so as you can see, there are carbon and there is one chlorine. There is one chlorine. So what do you think here? What do you think the reactivity? The reactivity depends on the carbon atoms. Carbon atoms, or I can say the alkyl chain. Or the Cl group. Yes, Mariam is right. On the Cl group, it will react. I guess others will also agree. Fatima, Amalia, and Ahmed will also agree that this alkyl groups, it does not depend on the alkyl group, obviously. The reactivity more depends on the Cl group, because if I have, for example, if I change the alkyl group like this, I mean, I'm taking now, there are 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'm taking just 1, 2. Both of them will react similarly. They both will react similarly. They will give same reaction. That means we have to identify these type of molecules. Okay. The reactivity depends on functional group. Okay. Now, what is different between this carbon and chlorine? What is the difference here? Why is chlorine different than carbon? What are the things that are different?
Chlorine is a functional.
Chlorine is functional group. But what is different in terms of chemistry and in terms of yes, Mariam is right. The most important thing is electronegativity. How is chlorine different from carbon? How is the molecules, they are not labeling them as chlorine and carbon. We are labeling them as chlorine and carbon. What they see in the reactant and in that containers and dabba in which they give the reactions, they just see what electrons and protons. So, but how chlorine is different? It is different in terms of its electronic configuration, and due to that electronic configuration, we have reactivity. I hope my previous student remember the chapter properties, the periodic table and periodic properties. Okay, the electronic configuration is the reason of all the properties in the atom and molecules. So in this particular here, the molecule is dependent on chlorine, and chlorine, due to its electronic configuration, is more electronegative element, and size, etc. Size is also different. That is also one matter. Okay, so this is more electronegative. Electronegativity is different here. Okay, so these are the things that we will see. So what happens due to electronegativity? It pulls electrons. So electron starts to displace, and this displacement of electrons leads to reactivity. So the next topic that we will learn in our next class is we will learn about electronic effects. The electronic effects are of two types mainly. One is permanent effects. Permanent effects are inductive effect. Inductive effects. Then we have resonance. And we have mesomeric effect. And we have at last hyperconjugation. Okay. And in temporary effect, we have electromeric effect. Okay. So organic chemistry is not tough. If you start reasoning out with the first principle, what is different? Why it is reacting? So you will keep getting answer from yourself only. What things are different? Mariam did a very good job today. She gave the very good answers. The electronegativity is different, and the resonance and the chlorine. Due to chlorine, we have the reactivity. Okay. Ahmed, done. Write the slide. Then we will leave this class. Okay. And remember the question number 25 of solution chapter. Remember question number 25. solution chapter. We'll discuss that on Sunday. We will now learn about electronic effects.
Sir, can you show the last slide? The one last which alkanes.
This one?
Yeah. Okay, fine. I'm done, sir. You can change the slide.
Yes, sir.
So what do you mean by hyperconjugation?
Maybe I've just written it. You just write it now. We will learn about hyperconjugation.
Okay, sir.
We will learn about it. Do you know about mesomeric effect?
No.
I know only resonance.
Hyperconjugation we will also learn. These are the effects. They're just names. We will know what it is more than what is the name. Okay, done with everyone? Everyone done?
Yes, sir.